Welcome to Civil Engineering Edge, where we uncover the fascinating science behind the structures that shape our world. Today's topic will answer a question you've probably asked while driving across a modern bridge. Why are some bridges hollow underneath? At first glance, it might seem like a way to cut corners, but the truth is far more impressive. In this video, we're diving into the brilliant engineering behind box girder bridges, why they're hollow, how they resist bending, and what makes them stronger, lighter, and longer lasting than older designs. You'll discover how centuries of bridge failures and breakthroughs have led to this innovative structure, now used in everything from expressways to iconic cable-stayed bridges. If you're a civil engineering student, a bridge enthusiast, or just someone who loves to learn how things work, this one's for you. So grab a seat and let's explore the hollow secret behind modern bridge design. Have you ever driven over a massive bridge and wondered, why does it look hollow underneath? Why don't all bridges have solid concrete or steel from end to end? The answer lies in one of the most revolutionary engineering concepts of the modern era, the box girder bridge design that combines strength, efficiency, and elegance to solve the challenges of modern infrastructure. Let's uncover the real engineering secret behind why some of the world's strongest bridges appear to be hollow. Over the last century, bridge engineering has undergone a dramatic transformation. Back in the early 1900s, bridges were bulky giants heavily built with steel trusses, short spans, and limited lanes. The average main span of a bridge around 1905 was barely 150 meters. These structures, though impressive at the time, were resource-heavy and lacked the versatility to handle today's fast-paced urban traffic. Fast forward to the present, and the landscape has changed completely. Now, bridge engineers can design and construct breathtaking spans of up to 2,000 meters thanks to innovations in materials, design, and above all, structural systems like the box girder. This shift wasn't by accident, it was forged through decades of trial, error, and even failure. Many of today's modern marvels, including cable-stayed bridges and elevated expressways, rely on this sleek, hollow box design to span longer distances while supporting more traffic with less material. It's a perfect example of how aesthetics and structural performance go hand in hand in modern civil engineering. So, what makes the box girder such a game changer? The secret lies in how it uses geometry to increase stiffness and strength. While older bridges relied on brute material volume, box girders leverage hollow rectangular or trapezoidal shapes to resist bending and buckling forces more efficiently. Structural mechanics plus box girder evolution. So, why do bridge girders have such deep sections and, more importantly, why are they often hollow? The answer begins with physics. When a bridge carries heavy vehicles or resists its own weight, it undergoes bending. To counter that bending moment effectively, girders must be designed with greater depth. This is directly related to how a beam deflects under load, and we can prove this with a basic engineering formula for beam deflection. Delta equals F times L, 48 times, E times I, where F is the applied force or load, L is the length of the beam, E is the modulus of elasticity, a measure of material stiffness, and 1 is the moment of inertia, a geometric property that reflects the beam's resistance to bending. Now here's the key. The deeper the beam, the higher its moment of inertia and the less it bends. A practical example. Think of a ruler. Lay it flat and it bends easily. Turn it on its edge and it's far more rigid. That's exactly why girders are deep. But building solid deep beams for long spans is inefficient. Using solid rectangular sections would drastically increase material usage, self-weight, and cost. That's where hollow sections, like box girders, come in. by removing material near the neutral axis where it contributes least to stiffness and keeping it concentrated away from the center. Engineers achieve greater bending resistance with less material. The moment of inertia of a hollow rectangular section is calculated by subtracting the inner rectangle from the outer, still delivering high strength with significantly lower weight. To prevent buckling in these thin walls, stiffeners are added. This principle is what led to the development of I-beams and eventually to box girders, which take it a step further. The box design links to vertical webs with continuous top and bottom flanges, forming a closed shape that resists twisting and buckling far better than an open section like an I-beam. When wider decks are needed to support more lanes of traffic, box sections, either rectangular or trapezoidal, are ideal. They provide a uniform platform, better aerodynamics, and higher structural efficiency. Although early box girder applications faced failures due to limited understanding, today's engineers use reinforced and pre-stressed concrete box segments, prefabricated off-site and installed with precision. Post-tension cables inside the girder boost strength, reduce bending, and help span greater distances, all while keeping the structure hollow and efficient. Performance, longevity, and practical application. The secret to the box girder's superior performance isn't just in its shape, it's also in its hollow core. The internal void inside a box girder isn't wasted space. In fact, it plays a vital role in how the bridge handles real-world forces. Air can circulate through this hollow section, helping to dissipate wind pressure, reduce aerodynamic drag, and minimize vibrations from passing vehicles. This improves both structural stability and comfort for drivers. Combined with the stiffness provided by its closed shape, the box girder is uniquely resistant to twisting and external stress. Because of this, modern box girder bridges are built to last with a typical design life of 100 to 150 years, far exceeding older truss bridge designs that typically last only around 100 years. Depending on the application, a single box girder can support deck widths up to 30 meters, and in some cases, even 50 meters, making them ideal for multi-lane highways and urban overpasses. And they're cost-effective too, reducing materials and maintenance over time. As bridge engineering continues to evolve, so do the limits of what box girders can achieve. While I-girder bridges typically span 20 to 50 meters, and truss bridges can reach up to 440 meters, box girder bridges can now extend to 100 meters, and in cable-stayed configurations, even up to 1. They are especially suited for medium to long spans, where strength, efficiency, and aesthetics must all be balanced. The choice of bridge type depends on the terrain, traffic volume, budget, and design goals, but it's no surprise that box girders are now the preferred solution worldwide. And there you have it, the hollow design of box girder bridges isn't just an architectural choice, it's an engineering revolution. From resisting dynamic loads to reducing construction costs and improving aerodynamics, these bridges have become the backbone of modern infrastructure. With lifespans stretching beyond a century and spans that reach up to 1,000 meters, it's clear why box girders are the preferred solution for highways, city overpasses, and even cable-stayed wonders. We hope this deep dive into bridge mechanics gave you a new appreciation for the brilliance behind these everyday structures. If you enjoyed this video, hit that like button and subscribe to Civil Engineering Edge for more insightful videos on construction technology, engineering marvels, and real-world design. Drop your questions or suggestions in the comments, we'd love to hear from you. Until next time, keep building your knowledge and keep looking up at the world's amazing structures. See you in the next video!